Hello friends, my name is Kishan and welcome you in this video tutorial. In this video tutorial, we are going to talk about the Spring Boot white label error message. So when you work on the any Spring Boot related web-based application, right, and if you try to hit some URL and resource does not exist for the particular URI, then you'll get the default error message. And that error message, default error page is called white label error message. So to show this demo, how to fix this white label error message, we'll see in this video tutorial. So let's go ahead and create a Spring Boot application. So go to the new, and here you have an option is called a Spring Starter Project, and let's select this option. And here I'm going to create a project with name Spring Boot white label error message demo. And package name I'm going to keep as it is, com.infotech.app, and let's click on the next. And here you have a Spring Boot version. So latest version of Spring Boot is 1.5.6, so that I'm keeping as it is. And here you have a lot of starter dependency project categories. So one of the categories is called web, so that I'm going to select web category, and I'm going to select the dev tools as well. So dev tools, basically this helps you to restart the server automatically when you make any changes in your Spring Boot source code project. Now let's click on the next and again click on the finish. Now our project is going to create in this workspace. So let's wait for a few seconds. Now this project is created in our workspace, and here you can see all dependency charts are added in our Maven dependency directory. And here if you go to the src main java directory, then you can see Spring Boot has added a class automatically. And before this class, you can see the annotation Spring Boot annotation, means this is your our bootstrap class, bootstrapping class, from where our application starts running, right? So now here I'm going to create a class, RESTful class in this. Here I'm going to create a package, com.infotech.controller. Okay, and I would say my controller. And this class I'm going to annotate as @ REST controller. And here I'm going to create a very simple RESTful API which will return us just a string as an argument, and I would say hello. And here this guy is going to return us a simple message, it's called hello world. Okay, and what I'll do, I'm going to annotate this method as request mapping. You may use a get mapping or request mapping, both will work over here. Request mapping, and here value I'm going to specify as slash welcome, and HTTP methods. If you do not specify any method, then default method will be get itself. Request method, you can specify a lot of methods, right? One of the method is called get. Even though if you do not specify any HTTP method, then get would be considered as default one. Okay, now we have a resource which is available on the path, is called slash welcome. Now let's run this project and try to access this resource by URI slash welcome. And here you can see the console. Now default embedded server is Tomcat. Now our application is going to deploy Tomcat server. So Tomcat is started on the ports 8080. Now go to the browser, and here I'll type http colon slash slash local host colon 8080 slash welcome. That's the our URL or URI of our resource. And if I try to access this, then sorry guys, that is http protocol, I had given the wrong. Now we are getting this error message, right? So this is a default error message which is provided by the Spring Boot. If any resource that is not available on the this path slash welcome, then you'll get this default error message from Spring Boot, right? So but what went wrong? Our resource we have defined with this path, right? Still we are getting resource not found, right? We are getting this error message, white level error message, and saying that this application has no explicit mapping for the slash errors. Basically, if you want the some custom error to be displayed on then any resource is not available for on particular URL, then if you want the custom error to be forwarded, then you can define a request handler method with slash errors, and that will be forwarded. If you do not define any request handler method with slash error, then this default error will be forwarded to you with the HTTP status 404, right? And they have given the timestamp as well and saying that no message available, right? So how to fix this error? So basically, if you look into the package hierarchy, then our bootstrap class is available on the this package com.infotech.app, and our controller is available on the some other package com.infotech. com.infotech till that this both package are matching, but after that both basically belongs to the different hierarchy. But if I drag our controller and put in the same package, right, I'm going to put in the same package where our bootstrap class is available, and here we have given we have configured dev tools in our pom.xml. So you can see when we have changed our package, right, controller package, then server has automatically restarted, right? And if you look into pom.xml, we have configured dev tools, right? So if you make any changes in our source code, then server will be restarted automatically because of this dev tool, right? Now if I hit the same URL, then we are getting this message, right? So what's the magic behind this thing is that if you keep this class in some other package, right, other package, again we have changed and server has restarted, right, dev tools is working fine, and if I press again enter, then we are not getting any proper response, right? So what's the magic? If I keep my controller in some other package, still I want to make it working. So how we can do that? So you will have to register this. In that case, you will have to register this in this package, right? Here we will have a @ component scan. Sorry, component scan. You will have to use this package, and your controller package basically have to register over here, right? You have a many packages. Then here you can see, if you look into the attribute of @ component package, you can see base packages, right? You can supply the array of packages here, array of packages you can supply over here, but we have only one package where our controller is present. After doing this modification, even though your controller belongs to the some other package, that does not comes to the hierarchy where your bootstrap class is available, still that is gonna run. So if after doing this modification, if you press enter, then our resources is defined by slash welcome, that is getting invoked properly, right? So I hope you understood this one, right? If your package is kept into the different package that does not comes under same package or same package hierarchy. What do you mean by same package hierarchy? So what we can do, we can create another package by clicking on this so our bootstrap class is available on com.infotech.app, right? And after that we create a controller like this. And so up to here, right, our package bootstrap class is available on the com.infotech.app, and after that I have given the dot controller, means and if I keep my controller over here, then still this is gonna work, because our controller class is available on the same hierarchy. If you go to this package, right, if you go to the this package app, com.infotech.app, and underneath we have a controller package, right? So this will be scanned by the our bootstrap class or Spring Boot, right? So in that case you don't need to basically define this component scan, even though if I comment it, right, in that case you don't need to basically define component scan. If you hit this URL, then this will pick up. See, this is working perfectly fine, right? This is working perfectly fine. So here key point is that if your controller is if you are keeping your controller in different package, and that package does not belongs to this hierarchy com.infotech.app, then you need to specify the @ component scan. But if your controller belongs to the same package or same package hierarchy, same package hierarchy means com.infotech.app.xyz.pqr, something like that, then you don't need to define this @ component scan. So that's all I wanted to show you in this video tutorial, right? So what I'll do, this controller package I'm going to put on the different package again, right, com.infotech.controller. In that case component scan is mandatory to specify, and this package I'm gonna delete, and let's run the server and make sure that this is working perfectly fine. Now server is up and running, and if I open this URL in another tab, then we are getting the response. But if I try to access some other URL like XYZ, then we'll get the default error page, right? So in some of the scenario you may have a requirement to customize this error page, right, default error page, which is provided by the Spring Boot application, right? So how to do that, how to provide our own custom error page, so that we will see in the next video tutorial. So thanks for watching this video, and see you next video tutorial.